that we are discussing, because in this chapter we are discussing about that how living organisms get the energy. So before this we have discussed about the photosynthesis, that how plants get the energy. Today we will discuss the respiration. You want to know about the respiration? That respiration have two types. One respiration is happen in our lungs, that is called breathing. Second is called is happen inside our cells. So that is called cellular respiration. So what is happen in the cellular respiration? First we will see the example which is given in your book. You can see when we burn a fuel. So what is happen at the time of oxygen and light and heat is produced. And because of in this burning process of oxygen is used to take the carbon hydrogen bonds present in fuel molecule. So because of that, energy is released and the vehicle began to move. So exactly this process is happen inside the body of a person. At the same way, what is happen at the time of organism? Organism means all living things. Utilize oxygen for the breakdown of CH bonds present in the food in their cell. First of all, question is there, how do we get the energy? We get the energy in the form of food. From then, when this food goes inside our body and when it gets oxygen, when oxygen is mixed with food, so it is responsible to break down the CH bond, carbon hydrogen bonds present in the food in the cell. So this breakdown yields energy. It is transported into ATP. We also discussed about the ATP molecule at this 9-5-phosphate in the start of the chapter, that it is an energy molecule which is produced during the utilization of food. So in simple words, we can say respiration is a process in which the food molecules are broken down because of the presence of oxygen, and they are broken down and converted into carbon hydrogen bonds. So the breakdown of these molecules, energy is transformed into ATP. So the energy which is produced, it is transformed, it is converted into molecules. So during this process, the CH bonds are broken by oxidation reduction reaction. Oxidation reduction reaction, we also discussed in the second page of this chapter. Oxidation means a removal of molecules, and reduction means the gaining of molecules. So this process is happened during this process. And carbon dioxide and water are also produced. The cellular energy generating process is called cellular respiration. This is very simple. When we get the food, if this food is broken down inside our body and converted into, and because of that carbon and hydrogen bonds which are present in our food, they are broken down in the presence of oxygen, and energy is transferred, and energy is converted into ATP molecule. ATP molecule is a molecule which is a more high energy molecule inside our body. Now we will discuss the types of cellular respiration. What is respiration? And it consists of two types. First is called aerobic respiration, and the second one is called anaerobic respiration. And anaerobic respiration further divided into two parts. So first we will discuss what is aerobic and what is anaerobic. So keep in your mind, aerobic respiration means in which your body needs oxygen. It is a process, and this process is happening in the presence of oxygen. And anaerobic respiration is that process in which oxygen is not needed. An means not, so in which oxygen is not required. So now we will discuss what is the process of aerobic and anaerobic. The most common fuel used by cell to get energy by cellular respiration is glucose. Yes, we all know when the food of energy which is produced inside our body, which has most high energy in it, that is a glucose. So we all of know the chemical formula of glucose, that it is equal to C6H12O6. So the way glucose is oxidized depends on the availability of oxygen. So glucose molecules can be broken down, but they will be broken down, they will be oxidized, depends on the availability of oxygen. If they get the oxygen, their bonds will be broken down. So what will be happen? The cellular respiration occurring in the presence of oxygen is called aerobic respiration, while the one that occurs in the absence of oxygen is called anaerobic respiration. And in both reactions, which thing is important? Glucose is important. So in those processes, glucose is broken down. So glucose will be broken down in the aerobic respiration. Why? Because in aerobic respiration, presence of oxygen is most important. This was the introduction of aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Now we will discuss in detail what is aerobic respiration and what is this process. In the presence of oxygen, complete oxidation of glucose occurs with maximum release of energy. In the first phase of aerobic respiration, a molecule of glucose, if you keep in your mind the chemical formula of glucose, it is equal to C6H12O6. It means it consists of six carbon compounds, six molecules of carbon. Okay, so this six molecules of carbon is equal to one molecule of glucose. So one molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid. So this molecule will be broken down and it will be converted into three carbon molecules. What will be happen? It will be broken down and convert into three carbon molecules. In the second phase, In the second phase, pyruvic acid are completely oxidized. All carbon hydrogen bonds are broken to carbon dioxide and water, and energy is released. The overall reaction is as follows. Now you understand whole this reaction with the help of a equation. This is an equation. This is a chemical formula of C6H12O6 and plus six molecules of oxygen. Okay. So this is a reaction. I have told you that when there is aerobic respiration, the most energy molecule inside our body is glucose. It's a chemical formula of glucose. So what will be happen when oxygen will added with this reaction? When oxygen is added with this reaction, it will broken down the carbon molecules. It will be broken down the carbon molecules into three carbon molecules, okay? And because of that, in this reaction, because of that, which product will be produced? Carbon dioxide and water will be produced and energy will be released. So this is a process at which our cells get the energy and make our body strong. I will explain you again. Here is a, it is a glucose molecule. When this glucose molecule oxygen is added in this glucose molecules, because of that, this is a six molecules of carbon. It will be broken down into three carbon molecules. You can also see here, it will be broken down into three carbon molecules. Okay, and when it convert into three carbon, so it will be called a pyruvic acid. So pyruvic acid are completely oxidized. All carbon hydrogen bonds are broken down to carbon dioxide and water and all energy is released. So because of this reaction, carbon dioxide will be produced and water will be produced and energy will be released in your surrounding. Energy will be released in the whole body. So this is the function of aerobic respiration. Now we will discuss what is anaerobic respiration. Another name of anaerobic respiration is fermentation. So what is anaerobic respiration? An means not. It means a process in which oxygen is not needed. So in the absence of oxygen, glucose is incompletely oxidized with less amount of energy is released. What will be happen? Glucose is incompletely oxidized. In this reaction, in above reaction, this is aerobic respiration, glucose is completely oxidized. Oxidized means removal of ions from its compound. Okay. So here it's a process in which glucose is incompletely, means its process is not completed, incompletely oxidized with less amount of energy release. And because of that, less amount of energy in this reaction, more amount of energy is released. In this reaction, less amount of energy will be released. In an aerobic respiration, the first phase is exactly similar to that of aerobic respiration. Okay, the first phase is same similar, glucose plus carbon dioxide plus oxygen. And in the second phase, a molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid. But in the second phase, pyruvic acid is not completely oxidized due to the absence of oxygen. As we have studied in this reaction, when this glucose is completely oxidized in the presence of oxygen, it will broken down and convert into three carbon molecules. And these three carbon molecules are called pyruvic acid. But this is different in anaerobic respiration. What is happened in this? Because we all of know, in anaerobic respiration, glucose do not show complete oxidation. It is incomplete oxidized. So what will be happen? A molecule of glucose is broken down into two molecules of pyruvic acid. It will be broken down and will convert into three carbon compounds. But in the second phase, pyruvic acid is not completely oxidized. But when it converts into three carbon molecules, in two parts, but it will not completely oxidize. Why? Due to the absence of oxygen. So it is transformed into ethyl alcohol or lactic acid. So what will be happen? It will be converted into ethyl alcohol, means it will produce alcohol or lactic acid, means fermentation of all things which are made by milk. In this way, many of the CH bonds are left unbroken in the product. In anaerobic respiration, because there is not completely reduction of carbon hydrogen bonds, so many should be left unbroken. So because of that, anaerobic respiration is further classified as alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid fermentation. I have told you in the start, respiration can be divided into two parts. That was aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. We have discussed aerobic respiration. We also discussed the introduction of anaerobic respiration. Now we are studying that anaerobic respiration further divided into two parts. First is called alcoholic fermentation. Second is called lactic acid fermentation. So what is the difference between two? In alcoholic fermentation, it is happened in bacteria, yeast, etc. In this type of anaerobic respiration, pyruvic acid is further broken down into alcohol. It's a chemical formula of alcohol, C2H5OH. Means it has two carbon molecules, five hydrogen molecules, one oxygen molecule, and one hydrogen molecule. So what is happened in alcoholic fermentation? Because we have discussed in anaerobic respiration, oxygen is not important. So first phase is same when glucose is broken down and convert into three carbon compounds, then it is called pyruvic acid. But pyruvic acid will not completely oxidize in second phase. And because of that, many things are left unbroken. So this is second phase, pyruvic acid again broken down and convert into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Pyruvic acid further divided into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. So it's a second phase, lactic acid and fermentation. So what is happen? It happens in skeletal muscles of human. Skeletal muscles, we all of know, which are related to our bones. Skeletal muscles of humans and other animals and during extreme physical activities. For if animals are doing extreme physical activities or in humans, it is produced in their skeletal muscle. For example, if a person is running very fast, definitely when it is running very fast, it needs oxygen, it needs energy. So how it gets energy? A person will get energy from their cells. So at that time, its body produce cellular respiration inside the body. Because of that, it can run fast. So lactic acid fermentation occurs in skeletal muscles of humans. When it needs energy, its muscles provide the energy to the human. And when the animals are doing extreme physical activities, so at that time, their cells do the cellular respiration and give energy to the animals. So this also happens in the bacteria present in milk. It is also happened in the milk. In this type of anaerobic respiration, each pyruvic acid molecule is converted into lactic acid. Each pyruvic acid molecule is converted into lactic acid. It's a chemical formula of lactic acid, C2H6O3. You have to underline for your MCQs. And this is also important. It's a formula of alcohol, C2H5OH. So these both formulas are very important. So pyruvic acid in lactic acid fermentation, pyruvic acid directly convert into lactic acid. And in alcoholic fermentation, pyruvic acid directly convert into ethyl alcohol plus carbon dioxide. So this is the process of respiration, how respiration is happen inside our body. I will give you the summary of respiration again. We all of know that all living things need breathing. Okay, they need energy. So our body gets energy in two ways. First, the energy the living organism get energy in two levels. First, they get energy from the cells, and second, they get energy from their body. So the second one is called breathing, and the first one is called cellular respiration. Cellular respiration means in which your cells respire and they produce energy inside the body. So respiration in which the carbon hydrogen molecules which are present in the food, they are broken down in the presence of oxygen and completely oxidized and produce energy in the body. Cellular respiration further divided into two parts, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration happen in the presence of oxygen, and anaerobic respiration is happen in the absence of oxygen. When there is an aerobic respiration, glucose is completely oxidized in the presence of oxygen and convert into three carbon molecules, pyruvic acid. And due to that, carbon dioxide and water is produced and energy is released in the body. Further, in anaerobic respiration, this process is happened in the absence of oxygen. In the first phase, same to aerobic respiration. First, glucose molecule is broken down and converted into three carbon compounds, pyruvic acid. So because of that, if there is absence of oxygen, so this process further divided into two parts. First is called alcoholic fermentation, and second is called lactic fermentation. In alcoholic fermentation, what is happened? Pyruvic acid directly convert into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. But when there is lactic acid fermentation, in this process, pyruvic acid directly convert into lactic acid. So their equations and formulas all are very important. So now there is our next topic, that is importance of fermentation. Why fermentation is important for us? So look at here. When life evolved on the earth, we are talking about the early life, when life was started on the earth in early times, the early land or water habitats did not have any supply of free oxygen. So what was the situation of the earth at that time? At that time, there was less supply of oxygen. There was no land or water habitats, and there was less supply of, there was no free oxygen. Free oxygen means that there is less amount of oxygen in the air. So in these anaerobic conditions, anaerobic means we all of know absence of oxygen or lack of oxygen. In anaerobic conditions, early organism respired anaerobically and got energy from their life activity. So the living organisms which were at that time, they respire, these organisms respire anaerobically and get energy for their life activities. Even today, when free oxygen is available, now there is a plenty of oxygen in the air. Free oxygen, there is a much ratio of oxygen in our environment, but still some organism, including some bacteria and some fungi, get energy from anaerobic respiration and are called anaerobes. Also underline in your book, its definition, what are anaerobes? Today, we have plenty of oxygen in the air. We have a lot of oxygen in our surrounding. But still, there are some organisms in our surrounding. For example, some bacteria or fungi. They are still getting energy for from anaerobic respiration. So that's why they are called anaerobes. So humans can also provide energy to their skeletal muscles through anaerobic respiration. This example I have already discussed with you. Humans can also provide energy to their skeletal muscles through anaerobic respiration. So what is happened? It happens when skeletal muscles have to work hard during exercise, etc. For example, if a person is doing hard exercise, so when it is doing its whole energy, its body is using the whole energy. So at that time, there should be not lack of oxygen inside their body. So how a person get the energy? A person get energy at that time from its skeletal muscles. So its skeletal muscles, how they get energy? They get energy from our blood. So how this energy comes into our blood? If this energy comes into our blood through food, so the food which we take inside our body, when it reaches inside our body due to aerobic respiration, there is complete oxidation of glucose molecules and they convert into pyruvic acid and they produce water and carbon dioxide inside our body. So you also remember this point. We all of know that there is less carbon dioxide in our surrounding as compared to our body. In our surrounding, we have 0.04% carbon dioxide. But when we exhale our breathing, we exhale 4% carbon dioxide from our body. So now you have to understand the difference. Okay, what is the difference between two? In surrounding, we inhale less carbon dioxide in our body. But when we exhale, when we take the out breathe from our body, we exhale 4% carbon dioxide. We exhale more carbon dioxide from its body. So from where this carbon dioxide comes, we also discuss that when glucose molecules is completely oxidized due to the presence of oxygen, because of that water is produced, which mix with our blood for biochemical reactions and carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide, then this blood goes each and every cell in our body, then cells get oxygen from the blood and they release carbon dioxide in the blood. So because of the excess amount of carbon dioxide, blood can be viscous. But this condition is also controlled by automatically because this blood when goes each and every cell, after that it again reaches to our lung. So when we breathe in and breathe out, so excess carbon dioxide is taken out from our body and that blood get more oxygen when we inhale inside our body, when we inhale oxygen inside our body. So this is a mechanism which is all time happening inside our body. Now we will see, but oxygen supply cannot be increased to fulfill the demand. But oxygen supply cannot be increased to fulfill the demand. Now scientists have used the fermenting abilities of fungi and bacteria for the benefit of mankind. So these lines are very important as a fermentation. You all of know this is a time of biotechnology, because all persons, and biotechnology is a field of bio. Biotechnology is a field of bio in which scientists are able to make useful things with the help of microorganisms. You all of know what are microorganisms. Micro means tiny, and organism means living things. Means such a living things which we cannot see by our naked eyes. Okay, so scientists have used the fermenting abilities of fungi and bacteria for the benefit of mankind. What is happening? Scientists have used the fermenting abilities of fungi and bacteria. Okay, so they scientists now are able to make useful things with the help of fungi and bacteria. And we all of know that fungi and bacteria, what are they? They are microorganisms, okay, for the benefit of mankind. And this is all happening in the field of biotechnology. So for example, the fermenting powers of bacteria are used for making cheese and yogurt. We all of know cheese and yogurt, they both are the part of our food. So how it is made? They also made by fermentation. So in fermentation process, bacteria are used to make cheese and yogurt. And fermentation in yeast is used in brewing and baking industries. So all bakery items, for them, yeast is used, and in brewing industry for making alcohol, yeast is also used by the scientists. Similarly, the soya sauce is made through the fermentation by a fungal aspergillus. Okay, so soya sauce, we all are familiar to soya sauce. It is the part of your Chinese food. Okay, so it is also made by a process which is called fermentation. And for this, the scientists used a fungus. We all of know fungus is also a microbe. It is also microorganism. So it is also used by a fungus which is called aspergillus. The name of that fungus is aspergillus. So it is used by the scientists to make soya sauce for Chinese food. So fermentation plays very, very important role in our everyday life. First of all, because of fermentation, we get energy. In early times, some organism have, there was no supply of oxygen. So the organism respired anaerobically and get energy for life activities. Today we have a lot of amount of oxygen in our surrounding, but what is happening? There are such organisms still on earth which respire anaerobically, and that's why they are called anaerobes. So human, when they do hard exercise, at that time they get energy from the skeletal muscle. So what are skeletal muscles? Skeletal muscles are those muscles which are connected to your bones. Okay, so they get energy from skeletal muscles, and skeletal muscles respire through anaerobic respiration. So skeletal muscles have to work hard. But oxygen supply cannot be increased to fulfill the demand. And you also have been observed this example. When you are running very fast and when you stop your running, what is happening? Definitely at that time you feel you are tired. So when you stop, you take long breaths. Why do you take long breaths? Because when you were running, your cells were respiring. They were giving energy and oxygen to your body. But when you have to stop, at that time, you have to breathe with your lungs. So there is lack of oxygen in your body. So because of that, you take long breaths to fulfill the lack of oxygen in your body. So these are the examples of aerobic and anaerobic respiration. and scientists and the last paragraph is related to your biotechnology. There is a field in biology, and you also have studied all careers in biology in chapter number one. Among them, there is a field which is for biotechnology, in which scientists are able to make useful things with the help of microorganisms for the benefit of mankind. Here are two examples are given. For example, fermenting powers of bacteria are used for making cheese and yogurt, and fermentation in yeast, in juice, in brewing and baking industries. These things are very important for your MCQs. And soya sauce is also made by a fermentation process, and it is made by a fungus which is called aspergillus. Okay, I hope you understand the lecture. Today we have discussed the respiration, types of respiration and importance of respiration. After that, in this chapter, your two topics are left, mechanism of respiration and the energy budget of respiration. So we will discuss these two topics in our next lecture. I hope you understand the lecture. If you have any confusion, if you want to ask any question, you can raise your hand. Now your lecture has been ended. Thank you so much.